What's up guys, my name's Brandon and Apple just released macOS Monterey 12.1 after going through beta testing for the past 7 weeks. And this is the first major update to macOS Monterey since the initial release back in October. And along with this macOS update, we also got iOS and iPadOS 15.2, tvOS 15.2, HomePodOS 15.2, and watchOS 8.3. But of course, this video is all about the Mac, and we're going to be covering all of the new features, changes, and bug fixes found in this latest 12.1 version. So let's go ahead and take a look at the size and the build number for this update. So you can see here, I'm using my 14-inch M1 Max MacBook Pro, and you can see here the update came in at 2.36 gigabytes from the previous build, which was 12.0.1. So you should expect a size under 3 gigabytes, so not too large here. And if we take a look at the build number, you can see it's 21C52. All right, so now what's new here in macOS Monterey 12.1? So we're gonna get a lot of the same features that we got in iOS and iPadOS 15.1 and 15.2 in this update. And the first one is SharePlay. So of course, this is the FaceTime feature where we can have synchronized experiences in FaceTime when you're watching a TV show, a movie, or when you're listening to Apple Music. You guys should know about this by now. This is the big FaceTime feature that was included with iOS 15. It's now finally made its way to the Mac. All right, so you can see I FaceTimed myself over here, and now with macOS Monterey 12.1, we have this new button in FaceTime that's going to allow us to share our screen. So if you press on that, it's going to take you to the menu bar up here for FaceTime, and you can see you can share your screen or just share a specific window, which is pretty cool. And then of course we do have SharePlay, which you're allowed to, you know, share your experience or have a synchronized experience when watching a movie, TV show, or listening to music. And if you were to press play on like a song, for example, you could see here, it asks you, how do you want to share play this song with everyone? You could play it now, next, or later. And of course it will start playing on your device and of course the person you're FaceTiming's device as well. So SharePlay is finally now on the Mac. And then for those of you expecting to see universal control with this update, unfortunately it has been delayed until the spring of 2022. You can see here Apple updated their website to now say available this spring. So it's unfortunate, but then again, I would rather have a more smooth, polished experience than Apple just rushing it out and having a buggy experience with universal control. So cannot wait for this to be released, but we're gonna have to wait until this spring to see it. We also have a new feature inside of the mail application. Just like with iOS and iPadOS 15.2, we now have the option to use Hide My Email straight from the mail application instead of having to do it from settings. So when you tap on the From field right here, you have the option to choose Hide My Email now. We also got Safari updated to version 15.2. So now we have 120 hertz when scrolling in Safari. Looks a lot smoother and a lot better, of course, than 60 hertz. If you go to your Safari and go to About Safari, you'll see here we're on version 15.2 as well. We also get the communication safety feature for children inside of the Messages application on the Mac as well. So this, of course, is a big feature for iOS and iPadOS to protect children from explicit photos, but that has also made its way to macOS with this latest 12.1 release. We also have some changes to the Photos application, mainly with the Memories feature right here. So this is a new splash screen with macOS Monterey 12.1, and you can see here we have Shared With You Memories. So it says discover a new interactive memories experience, including a soundtrack curated for you. And then of course we have visual lookup as well with this update. So if we go to the memories tab here, you can see just some minor changes to the UI. And of course, if we tap these three dots right here, you have the option to do short, medium, or long, or edit the title of this memory. And you can see here in the release notes, Apple mentions new memory types include additional international holidays, child-focused memories, trends over time, and improved pet memories. So I guess this is an improved pet memory here with this update. So I think it looks pretty solid. Shows some pretty good pictures right there of my cats. Inside of the TV application, we now have a store tab where we can rent and buy movies all in one place. You can select right here, movies or TV shows to kind of filter it. And you can see all of your options here where you can rent or buy. So it's nice to have the standalone store tab now. And then also just like in iOS and iPadOS 15.2, we now have the option to select people as legacy contacts so they can access your iCloud account and personal information in the event of your death. So something you don't always think about, but it is important to have a legacy contact set up so that your data can be passed down. And then of course, we do also have the Apple Music voice plan available for macOS Monterey 12.1 as well. So this will carry across, of course, all devices, but you can now, you know, sign up for that if you wanted to on the Mac. We also have some minor changes inside of the stocks application. So now when you go to a stock, you now have a year-to-date option for the charts. So before it just said 6 months and then 1 year, there was never a year-to-date. So it now has that right there. Also under the ticker, it will show the stock exchange that this stock is under and the currency that you're currently using. So mine is USD, so it shows that now right here with this update. And then as far as bug fixes go, we do have quite a few mentioned here, but I also wanted to mention a couple that were not mentioned in the release notes, but let's go ahead and cover these first. So desktop and screensaver may appear blank after selecting photos from the photos library. That has been fixed. Also, the big issue with the trackpad, where it would become unresponsive to taps or clicks, has been fixed. That drove me absolutely crazy on the previous build of macOS Monterey. I just couldn't even use my trackpad anymore. So thankfully that has been fixed. Also, external displays may not charge some MacBook Pro and MacBook Air computers when connected using Thunderbolt or USB-C. I never had that issue and I use an external display with my MacBook Pro, but if you were having that issue, it has been resolved. Also, the massive YouTube HDR bug has been fixed with this update. So if you have a 2021 MacBook Pro and you tried to watch an HDR video on YouTube in Safari, it would cause your device to reboot. It would have a kernel panic and it drove me and everybody nuts. So now after updating, you're able to watch HDR videos as intended. Another big complaint with the 2021 MacBook Pros with the notch, the menu bar extras are not obscured by the what Apple is calling the camera housing. So the camera housing is the notch on the new MacBook Pros. And now if you have, you know, menu options that go all the way to the middle, which you have to have a ton of applications to have that. But if they go all the way over here, it's now not obscured by the notch. You're going to be able to actually see all your menu items. I guess it's just going to skip over that and continue down here past the notch. So I will never have that many menu items, but if you do, that has been fixed. And then also we have a fix for MagSafe when it would stop charging on the 2021 16-inch MacBook Pro. And then aside from the bug fixes that Apple mentioned, I did also want to point out that Vsync works. So a lot of people had issues with Vsync on previous builds of macOS Monterey, but that has been fixed and now Vsync works properly on 12.1. And then I also wanted to mention memory leaks because a lot of people had issues with memory leaking in macOS Monterey. So hopefully 12.1 fixes that. That of course does take time to see if it's been fixed or not. Apple did not mention it in the release notes, so that is kind of concerning. But I personally have not had any issues with memory leaking on my device. But I'll let you guys know if that has been fixed or not in a later video. And then as far as the security patches go, we have a ton of bugs that have been patched in this update. So if you scroll down the list here, you can see a ton of things have been patched. We have kernel bugs, we have WebKit bugs, we have all types of things that have been patched in this update. So if you care about security at all and protecting your information, you know, of course you do want to go ahead and update to keep your device as secure as possible because there are quite a few bugs that have been patched here. And as far as performance overall, performance actually feels better here in macOS Monterey 12.1. It seems like a lot of things are just more fluid overall than they were on previous builds. So everything feels great as far as performance goes. As far as battery life goes, of course, I am using an external display, so I never really test the battery life on my MacBook Pro here, but I would not expect any major hits to battery life. It could get better. I would expect it to get better if anything, but you guys will have to let me know down in the comments below if your battery life got better or worse after updating here to macOS Monterey 12.1. But anyways, guys, there you have it. That is macOS Monterey 12.1. I think it's a great update for everybody. No matter what device you're on, you should go ahead and update to macOS Monterey 12.1. It's the first big update to macOS Monterey since it came out initially again back in October. So highly recommended to update for the bug fixes alone. And of course, the features are a nice added bonus. Of course, a lot of the features were already in iOS and iPadOS. So nothing groundbreaking here with the feature set. But if you guys enjoyed this video, I would appreciate if you gave it a thumbs up. And of course, make sure to subscribe for a lot more macOS and iOS update videos. Also leave a comment down below with which Mac you updated to 12.1. I'm really curious to see what machines you guys are using out there. But anyways, guys, thanks again for watching and I'll see you soon.